If you put a cold ice cube onto a hot pan, obviously heat will flow from the pan to the ice cube, hot to cold. So how do we do the opposite, move heat from something cold to something hot, like we do in our refrigerators? We could get into PV diagrams, phase transition diagrams, and latent heats, but let's boil it down to the basics. First off, the boring part, some definitions. Gas molecules are always in motion, banging into each other and their surroundings. Temperature, like you would measure in any ordinary thermometer, is a measure of their average kinetic energy, or basically their speed. Hot ones move quickly and cold ones laze around. Volume, as you probably know, is how loud something is, but in this context, it's how much space something takes up. Pressure can be thought of as how often gas molecules collide with the walls of their container. These three values, describing a gas, share a relationship described by the ideal gas law. If you put gas in a container which can't change volume, increasing its temperature would increase its pressure. One way to think about this is that the faster molecules are moving, the more often they'll collide with the container walls. Think about a pressure cooker. You heat it up, and its pressure increases, but it's a special piece of equipment that can handle that high pressure. The opposite is true as well, that decreasing the temperature would decrease the pressure. These relationships still hold even if you change pressure first. Changing the pressure on a gas changes the temperature in the same direction. One last definition before we get to refrigerators, and that's heat, which is distinct from temperature. Let's say you put two blocks next to each other, one that's hot and one that's cold, both of which, by the way, are descriptions of temperature. Heat is the energy that travels from the hot block to the cold block until they equalize in temperature, at which point there is no more heat traveling between them. Additionally, for a liquid to evaporate into a gas, it needs to absorb heat, and when it condenses back into a liquid, it gives off heat. Phew, still with me? Then on to refrigerators, which have four main parts: a compressor, condenser coils, an expander, and evaporation coils. The compressor takes in a refrigerant and increases its pressure and therefore its temperature. The resulting hot gas then flows through the condenser, which is in contact with the relatively cool kitchen air, allowing it to give off heat and condense down to a liquid, whereby it gives off more heat. It then travels through an expander, which rapidly drops its pressure and likewise its temperature, before moving through the evaporation coils. This now very cold liquid absorbs heat from the refrigerator contents, raising its temperature until some of it vaporizes into a gas, by which it absorbs further heat. The resulting mixture travels back to the compressor to restart the cycle. So refrigerators are pretty cool. They bring a third party to the situation, namely the refrigerant, and some electrical power to cool down their insides and give off heat to their exterior, a net movement of heat from cold to hot. But sorry, SpongeBob, this means you can't cool down your kitchen simply by opening the refrigerator door. If you like this video, how about giving it a like or sharing it on social media? Be sure to follow Everyday Elements on Facebook and my new Twitter page. Thanks for watching.